today our topic is about if two states are, if two observables or two operators are commuting with each other, they will have our same eigen states. Okay? So, yes. Mean if two things are commuting, there they will measure the same. If two physical observables, if there are two physical observables and they are measuring the if they are commuting, then their measuring state, eigenstate means measuring state, they will measure the simultaneously at that state. Mean if momentum and free Hamiltonian Hamiltonian not always commute with the momentum, but free, I am talking about the free Hamiltonian. If you have a free Hamiltonian, you know that that will be function of P. It will be always commute with the, we know that if H is Hamiltonian, if H is free Hamiltonian, okay, free Hamiltonian, that will be function of P, okay? And it will commute with the P, or P square. When it will commute with the P square, they will have a same eigenstate. Means the eigenstate of H and P will be the same. That will be the eigenstate of P as well as it will be eigenstate of H. Same. So if two operators are two physical measurable things, they will be simultaneously measured, okay? They may be simultaneously measured. Why? Because they have the same eigenstate, okay? Now, this was the examples. Now, the customs of our physics class, that we will kindly please switch off your mobile. We will not only claim, but we will prove everything, okay? So if you have two operators, let's suppose you have two operators, alpha and beta, okay? If alpha and beta are classical observables, okay? Yes? मैं लिखने लगा, बता रहा हूँ, आप लेट आए हो ना, असल में कोशिश किया करो कि टीचर को वेट ना करना पड़े, क्लास में आपको वेट करना पड़े, तो ठीक है. सो मैं दोबारा लिख रहा हूँ, ठीक है. तो काइंडली एक तो सबर करके सुन लिया करो, ठीक है. तो हम थ्योरम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं. द थ्योरम इज इफ टू ऑपरेटर्स आर कम्यूटिंग दे विल हैव द सेम आइगनस्टेट आर दे मेजर्स the simultaneously state, okay? If you have a two operator, let's suppose alpha and beta, if alpha and beta are two operators, if alpha beta are two operators corresponding to two classical observables, alpha and beta as two distinct classical observable, if alpha beta are two operator corresponding to alpha beta commutating, if they are commutating, they are commutating with each other, okay? If alpha and beta are two commutative operator corresponding to alpha and beta as two distinct mean different classical observables, they will have same eigen states. They may have a different eigenvalue, but they have the same eigenstates. Okay, that is only about the eigenstates, not eigenvalues. Okay. Proof. Or we may prove it. We will consider that alpha and beta are two operators. Okay, they are two commutative operators. Okay, let if they are commuting, alpha and beta are two commutative operators. Okay, they are two different, two distinct operators. Okay, commuting mean, I have already told you that if they are commuting, then that mean alpha and beta, their commutation relation will be a zero. Okay, mean if we are applying on the any state psi, let's suppose this psi is any state, I am not claiming that that is the eigenstate, okay, that is equal to zero. Okay, what is the meaning of this, that two is commuting? We know that commutative operator mean alpha beta minus beta alpha equal to zero. Okay, or we can say that this commutative mean alpha beta psi operator, that will be equal to beta alpha psi operator. Okay, so that will be, if you change the order commutative mean, if you change the order, there will be no change in the result. Okay, that is all the simple up till yet. Okay, no problem is that if alpha is any operator and if alpha is eigen operator, okay, let alpha is eigen operator. Okay, if alpha is applying eigenvalue, what is the second postulate? If we apply an eigen operator on its eigen state, it will give you the eigenvalue. Okay, and this will be eigen vector. Okay.
जो हम स्टेट का है, अगर ये अपनी ही स्टेट से अप्लाई होता है तो फिर ये आइजन वैल्यू देते हैं, अगर किसी और स्टेट
नहीं देता
तो सर वैल्यू तो स्टेट की कोई सेम ही रहेगी.
नहीं नहीं, when alpha operate, it will give you eigen value and the state will remain the same. Okay, अब यही लिखा है, alpha it will remain the same. Okay, and there is no change. These are the eigenstate and they are same. Yes, you are right. That is the eigenstate, yes. And this is eigenvalue, and this will be eigenoperator. Why I have written alpha mean, I have to represent that that is the state of this is eigenstate of alpha operator. Okay, as I have written in the case of momentum and Hamiltonian in the previous lectures. Okay. 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 If alpha is applying on this, this will give you this. Okay. Alpha is applying this. Okay. Okay. If I say this is a question X. Okay, please be silent, please. If we apply alpha, if I multiply both sides with beta, okay, May I write in this way? Okay. This is eigenvalue A. Okay. If you are interested to write alpha, yes, you are right. You may write A. This is a number, simple eigenvalue. Okay.
Nein.
Operator will be always apply on the their on eigen state. I have this, that was the second postulate. Okay. Okay. So that will give you the eigenvalue alpha. And that will be eigenstate. Okay, so this will be eigenvalue. Alpha, all constants, eigenvalue is like a numbers, and that will be commute with these this operators. So alpha will come out. Okay, and from equation x, from equation x. Beta alpha psi, sorry, alpha, that is alpha, that will be equal to beta alpha alpha. Yes?
Yes.
In left hand side, and beta operator and alpha will be equal to alpha beta at right hand side. Okay, because the alpha is the number at eigenvalue. Okay, if you write it in the form of A, that will become out. Okay, so putting this at left side and that at right side, you will get alpha. Yes. This is the eigenvalue and this is number, this is eigenstate. Okay, sorry. Now it's okay. Thank you. Thanks for correction. Okay, so this will become alpha beta alpha. May I write it in this way? And this will become alpha beta alpha operator. Okay, we may write it
same.
Same. Okay. Alpha is eigenvalue. Okay. Okay. Alpha is eigenvalue. Writing with different color, alpha is eigenvalue. Okay, that is not operator. नहीं है? Phi? अच्छा alpha, I have already explained. Psi always usually I use for the complete eigenstate of Hamiltonian or complete state. But alpha and beta, O operator, actually it usually represents the eigenstate of given operators. Here alpha in the cat, within the cat, is representing the eigenstate of alpha operator. Okay, well, that's the difference for understanding. वैसे तो आप कुछ भी use कर सकते हो. But actually, I am interested to represent the alpha as the eigenstate. Okay, eigenstate of alpha. Okay, I always use the O state as a eigenstate of operator O. A state is eigenstate of A. That's why I have written. Okay. Okay, so you know me, you may easily observe when we are applying alpha operator on this operator or this state, if I say that this is a state, not operator, if I say that this thing is the same, that is repeating. Okay, you may say that this is also an eigenstate of the same alpha. Yes? So now alpha is applying on this. Okay, alpha is applying on this state, giving the same state. Yes, I'm saying that because this is a, so that will, that must be this eigenstate of this. because it's giving the this value constant. When this is applying the, on this and this is giving as a eigenvalue, so it means the state is remaining the same. So it means this is also eigenstate of. Yes, but this is operator and that will be also our eigenstate. Okay, beta is applying on this and this will be give you the state. The state, there is no change in state. So this is the again eigenstate of operator alpha, okay, with same eigenvalue, with same eigenvalue, that is, what is the that eigenvalue? Eigenvalue is alpha. 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 Beta and alpha is eigenstate of operator alpha with same eigenvalue alpha. Okay. So alpha is applying on this and this is eigenstate. Okay. यही हम प्रूव करने लगे हैं कि दिस इज स्टेट इज द स्टेट ऑफ अल्फा एज वेल एज द बीटा. ठीक है. ओके, थोड़ा सा आगे चलो. ओके ओके, अभी हम बी को एज ए ऑपरेटर नहीं ले रहे. दिस इज द आइगन स्टेट. ओके, देयर आर नो टू डिफरेंट पॉसिबिलिटीज. One is possibility that alpha is this alpha is eigenstate of alpha as well as the beta. Mean they are the same state. And the other possibility they may be a different different. Okay. If alpha has according to this alpha has two eigenstate. One is according to this one state is this and one state is this. Mean this implies that alpha and beta alpha are two eigenstate of alpha operator with same eigenvalue. That is alpha. If you have a two distinct operators, if you have a same operator but two distinct eigenstate may be a two different. Okay, I will explain it later. If you have a two distinct eigenstate and eigenvalue is repeating, that is the course in the linear algebra course. I have already explained it many and many times in the linear algebra course, and the video is also available on linear algebra course. That states are defined as, or that function is defined as degenerate function. Okay, I will explain it. Let's suppose there are two terms. One is the alpha and beta are a dependent function. One is they are independent. So they are two different alpha and beta are two states. They may be like a same state or linear combination of the linearly dependent. Okay, and they may be a linearly independent. Linear independent means they may be a totally different state and they may be a same state. Okay, these two states alpha and beta alpha may be linearly डिपेंडेंट और इंडिपेंडेंट। ठीक, स्टेट्स ऑफ अल्फा ऑपरेटर, ओके, दे मे बी अ डिपेंडेंट और दे मे बी अ इंडिपेंडेंट, ओके। एंड if two things are dependent, I have already explained in the CM course and linear algebra course, if two things are depending, they will be a form of constant multiplication, that may be a function of, okay, each other, they will be depending upon. If they are not independent, they will be their linear combination, they will be independent, they will be a different, okay. So firstly we consider that are dependent, we will consider a simple, okay. If number one, if alpha and beta alpha is are two dependent state of two dependent eigen state of operator alpha, if alpha and beta are two dependent eigenstate of operator alpha, okay, then they will be a linear combination, means alpha then nahi इधर आएगा, सॉरी, यस, इफ अल्फा एंड दिस आर लीनियरली इंडिपेंडेंट देन बीटा अल्फा विल बी लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मीन दैट विल बी दिस लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन कॉन्स्टेंट मल्टीप्लाई द कॉन्स्टेंट विद दी एम अल्फा, ओके। I will explain intermittently, I will explain it in such a way, if this is a alpha state, okay, or a psi state, okay, because you mostly now be familiar with the psi and not alpha, that's why I am writing the psi, don't need it, but for explaining, okay. If this is state, okay, if I multiply with the constant, any constant, if I multiply with the constant, that will remain the on the same state, the state will not change, but if I multiply with the number, this blue line will be a CM, a C alpha M, okay, C alpha, okay, and this will be a new state, that is beta alpha. Black is alpha state and blue is geometrically, this will be alpha. When we multiply constant, the direction remain the same, the direction will be the line of the action will remain the same, okay. When we multiply vector with the constant, the vector will remain the same, but length will be changed, okay. So no, यस, बट इट इज आइगन स्टेट, ऑपरेटर कुछ भी हो सकता है, वो बाद में एक्सप्लेन करेंगे, ठीक है। ऑपरेटर, ऑपरेटर इज द ऑपरेशन कोरस्पॉन्डिंग टू एज मोमेंट, इन द केस ऑफ मोमेंटम यू हैव प्रूव दैट इज माइनस एओटा एच कट करली बाई करली एक्स, इन द केस ऑफ एनर्जी दैट इज एओटा एच कट करली बाई करली टी, इन द केस ऑफ एक्स दैट इज विल बी द एक्स, दैट्स फॉर डिफरेंट ऑपरेटर, physical observables or physical quantity, there will be different operators, that must be a Hermitian if that is related to the physical physical observables, they will be Hermitian, but if they are not related to the physical observable, they may be a non-Hermitian quantity. So I think you must focus on this, okay. So this will be, you will get this, okay, if you, that is the linear combination, okay, yes. Okay, and this C is a linear, if that is a linear dependent, then the state is same. If that is the linear combination, the state is linear combination, and the operator is giving this C. This C will be eigenvalue of alpha. Okay. Now, you may write a beta, but I have written as a C because I want to say that I have multiplying with it. Okay. You are right. So from this equation, but this equation represent, this equation says that C is eigen value of beta operator with same state alpha. Okay, so alpha is the state, alpha is the eigenstate with the same eigenstate. So it's proved that the alpha is eigenstate of, it must be, if two operators are commuting, if alpha and beta are commuting, then the alpha will be the eigenstate of alpha as well as the beta. Okay, clear. Now question is, that is the very simple case, if two are things are dependent, but maybe two things are not independent, they are independent, they are not depending upon each other. For dependent, they are a safe forward, but for independent, the combination, case will be a complicated, little bit complicated. Okay, so if we consider it, if we consider the second case, if two, these two states are independent, may I rub it? Please let me allow. But in second case, if two are independent,
if alpha and beta,
if alpha and beta, alpha, no, if alpha and beta that are eigen operators, that are eigen states, okay, are two independent eigen state of operator alpha. Independent, okay. Yes. Then they must not be passing through a single line. They will be, they have a different mean. And the one state is this, one state is this, this, okay. If this is alpha state, if two are a different state, they are linearly dependent, okay. Then beta, alpha, okay, so they have two eigenstates. Yes, that's right. One is alpha state, and one way will be this. Okay, clear. Now you have two eigenstates, alpha state and this, and these are the both are this eigenstate, both are eigen state of same operator alpha with same value, with same eigen value, with same eigen value alpha. Okay. Both are the same eigen, both are the two distinct eigenstates of the same operator alpha with same eigenvalue. Okay. Okay. But we know from the superposition principle, all the eigenstates will be obey the superposition principle, that if two independent, two are a distinct state of the same operator, their linear combination will be also the eigenvalue of the same operator. We have already, if I say that this is, let's suppose this is phi 1 state, if this, okay, I think, no, I don't need, if alpha and beta are two independent operators, independent eigenstate of alpha with same eigenvalue is alpha. If the two states have the same eigenvalue, if two distinct states have the same eigenvalue, that will be defined as a, that will be defined as a degenerate eigenvalue. If two distinct eigen state of same eigen operators have same eigen value, then these eigen value, will be defined as degenerate eigen value, please, for distinct eigenstates. Okay, so that will be the eigenstate. So then alpha and beta are the, these are the eigenstates. These are the eigenstates, but have the same eigenvalue. Okay. Operators are the same. The eigenstates are distinct, and that state will be defined as a degenerate state, and that value will be defined as a degenerate values. Okay? Eigenvalue. Okay. If alpha and beta are two distinct independent operators, eigenstate, then their linear combination will be the eigenstate of the same operator. Since alpha, if psi 1 and psi 2 are two independent eigen state of same, degenerate state eigen state of same operator, with same eigen value, then there linear combination will be also the eigen state will be also the degenerate eigen state of same operator. I will explain it. Okay. प्लीज कम बोला करो, ठीक है? किधर गया? कम, अच्छी बातें ज्यादा किया करो, बुरी बातें कम। अच्छा, समझने की कोशिश करो। इफ आई आर टू इंडिपेंडेंट डीजनरेट आइगन स्टेट ऑफ सेम ऑपरेटर ओ, मीन इफ यू आर अप्लाइंग ऑपरेटर ओ ऑन साई वन, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग दैट दैट इज गेनिंग द ओ आइगन वैल्यू ओके वन and operator on apply on psi 2, then that will be eigenvalue will be the same, that will be the, that is psi 1 and psi 2 are two distinct eigenstates, okay, of operator O, then their linear combination will be also the if we sum that if we write that is, because you know that, yeah, we can easily prove it also, okay, if we write that psi 1 plus psi 2, okay, okay, this will be equal to this, okay, and if I write C1 O psi 1 plus C2 O 2 psi 2. May I write in this way?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I'm proving this this statement. This statement. Okay. Some exercise. You can say that the. Please wait. If operator is applying on a psi 1 operator, okay, O is eigenvalue and psi 1, and O is applying on a distant eigenstate, psi 2, then that will be give the same eigenvalue with the eigenstate. So they are a two distinct eigenstates. If I add these two things, okay, no. C1 is any arbitrary constant, okay, 2, 3, 6, कोई भी arbitrary constant, मैंने किसी से, first equation, I have multiplied the first equation with C1, and I have multiplied the second equation with the C2, and add, okay, some, थोड़ा सा दिमाग को तेज चलाओ, ठीक है, तो, okay, so, if we multiply both sides, then this will be a C1, O, psi 1, okay, plus C2, O, psi 2, okay, this will be the result.
Yes,
I have multiplied the C1 and C2 with the equation. If this is equation 1 and if this is equation 2, okay.
Why
is this? I explain it because I am trying to prove this theorem, okay? Okay. Okay. So, no, this are operator left, at left side there are operators and right side there are eigenvalue, okay? So, C1 is constant, so it will come into the right side, it will be transferred into, so I can write in this way, operator is as a C1, psi 1 plus C2, psi 2, okay, oh, I have taken the O as a comma, okay,
okay,
okay. And equal to eigenvalue O C1 Psi1 plus C2 Psi2. Okay, so you will get this. Yes, this is operator, this is eigenvalue, this is the state. Okay, so if I say that this is psi operator, and if I say that psi operator, this psi is same eigenstate, this psi is different eigenstate, okay, mean linear combination of all eigenstates with the same eigenvalue O, with the same operator O. ठीक है, सो दिस वाज द थ्योरम, लिख लें आप थ्योरम क्या है जो हमने प्रूव किया है, सो वी हैव प्रूव आरबीसी कांस्टेंट जनरल के लिए लिया है, मतलब अगर इफ दैट इज मल्टीप्लाई विद द कांस्टेंट आर नॉट मल्टीप्लाइड, वन इज आल्सो कांस्टेंट, C1 मे बी अ वन, यू आर राइट, अब C1 वन है तब भी दोस्त है, C1 वन नहीं है तो तब भी दोस्त है, सो दैट्स व्हाई वी मस्ट राइट द लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन, ओके, नॉट if they are dependent, it is true. If they are not, for dependent, that is a very simple you get answer. If they are dependent, even then that is solution. If that is not dependent, even then that is solution. Okay. If I are two, yeah, two. So this is theorem. Okay. If psi 1, psi 2 are two independent degenerate eigenstate of same operator with same eigenvalue, then their linear combination will be also the degenerate eigenstate of the same operator with same eigenvalue. ठीक है, with the same eigenvalue. Okay, so this is the theorem. Okay, and this is the proof. You have taken the same as eigen operator, O is the same eigen operator. You have taken two distinct eigenstate, that is psi1 and psi2. Okay, when O operator is applying, that is giving the one value, that is O operator, O value, and equation two, the value O value is repeating, that is mean that is degenerating. So when we take what we have done, we have multiply C1 with equation 1 plus C2 multiply with the equation 2, then we get this result. Okay, and that's we get this result. Okay, so by adding this, we have taken the common O, then this I have defined this, so this is giving the this state is giving the linear as the this, so means this is the proof, required proof. Okay, so if two states are distinct, okay, even but they have a same eigenstate, they have a same eigenvalue, then their linear combination will be also the eigenstate of the same operator. So this if you say according to this theorem, this I have proved that. No, I can. May I erase, or I should? I think I should erase. Nahin, state are not equal. Eigenvalues are same. Eigenvalue are degenerate. So this is not eigenvalue degenerate value of R1, but it is eigenvalue of R2. Okay. Yes. This is yes. This O is eigenstate. Same eigenvalue. O is eigenvalue of this. O is eigenvalue of this, and O is also the eigenvalue of linear combination.
Yes. Nahin.
Operator after O is not equal to O. O operator when applying on this state, this will give you this value. Otherwise not. Okay. Operator. This is eigenvalue, not a. Yes. Nee, if they are different, yes. If they are different, then this is also the. If they are the same, then they will be a. Mean that will become add will be as a combination. I have they become a dependence. I have proved already. They will be also make up.
Dependent.
अच्छा different होने के बावजूद भी अगर ये function है इसका, तो तो इस पर डिपेंडेंट होंगे, तो कांस्टेंट नंबर ऐड हो जाएगा, मतलब ये दिस इज अ फाइव वन दिस इज फाइव टू, तो आपके साथ ये क्या बन जाएगा अगर आप ये कह रहे हो ना सेम। मैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं एक बात करता हूँ, बार बार एक ही बात पूछी जा रही है, इसलिए मेरा ख्याल है मैं इसे करके बताऊँ तो ज़्यादा बेहतर है। एक मिनट प्लीज, मैं पहले बता दूँ फिर आपके सवाल का जवाब मिल जाएगा। यू आर सेइंग कि इफ टू आर अ सेम, ठीक है, मीन इफ सी वन साई वन प्लस सी टू साई वन बन जाए दिस बिकम अ सी, ओके, इफ टू आर अ सेम, ठीक है, दिस यू ओके if psi 2 is you are saying that if psi 2 is psi 1 what will be happen, yes you want to ask this, okay, then we may write that, may I write in this way, C1 is any constant, C2 is arbitrary constant, when we add C1 and C2 that will be another constant, C3 5. That is the firstly I have defined that if I think I have arrayed already when two dependent I have already said if psi 1 and psi 2 is that dependent then that will be after this form, okay, that's the case, okay? They will be a depending upon, but if they are distinct then they will be independent, okay, okay. स्टेट आर नॉट सेम, ऑपरेटर्स आर द सेम, आइगन वैल्यू इज सेम, स्टेट आर इफ स्टेट आर सेम देन दे विल बी डिपेंडिंग, नो साई वन इज डिफरेंट स्टेट साई टू इज डिफरेंट स्टेट, आई हैव गिवन द नेम दिस स्टेट एज psi, आई हैव गिवन द नेम, दे आर द टू डिफरेंट स्टेट एंड द psi मीन लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस टू स्टेट, नहीं नहीं नहीं, हमेशा ऑपरेटर अप्लाई करने के बाद अपनी वैल्यू देता है, जैसे कि मैंने आपको हमेशा कहा कि किसी पे सम अप्लाई करते हैं जब तक सम कर रहे हैं सम का और रिजल्ट है, डेरिवेटिव को अप्लाई करो तो डेरिवेटिव उसके बराबर नहीं होता, डेरिवेटिव अप्लाई होने के बाद उसकी वैल्यू देता है, तो इट नेवर मीन दिस इक्वल टू दिस, ये बट दिस इज ऑपरेटर दिस इज आइगन वैल्यू, सो नहीं दिस इज आफ्टर अप्लाइंग द वैल्यू, मैं एक मिनट यार आई या आप लोग फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं एक एक्सरसाइज में वैसे प्रूव कराना आप दूसरी तरफ ले जाते, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपने लिखा e की पावर सिक्स है, दिस इज स्टेट, ओके, दिस इज आइगन स्टेट ऑफ ऑपरेटर ओ इज डी बाई डी एक्स, ओके, ऑपरेटर इज डी बाई डी एक्स नॉट सिक्स, ओके, इफ यू अप्लाई ऑपरेटर डी बाई डी एक्स ऑन ई सिक्स एक्स, ओके, व्हाट विल बी द आइगन वैल्यू, सिक्स, ठीक है, डी बाई डी एक्स डी ई एक्स ई सिक्स एक्स, ओके, एंड ओके डी एक्स बाई डी एक्स इज वन, ओके, एंड दिस डी बाई डी एक्स ई सिक्स एक्स इक्वल टू सिक्स ई सिक्स एक्स, दिस इज द स्टेट, ओके, आइगन वैल्यू इज सिक्स बट डी बाई डी एक्स को हमेशा आप सिक्स नहीं कहोगे, सो दैट मीन्स द ऑपरेटर एंड आइगन वैल्यू इज डिफरेंट, दैट विल टेल the value about value after operating. You can't apply the this and this. That is wrong. You can't do it. Okay, this is wrong. मेरे ख्याल आप आपको समझ आ जाए. Okay, actually this is. So please. Okay. So I think now it is. No, हमें ये प्रूव करना है, ठीक है. Okay. So this will be the result. Okay. अब आपको क्लियर हो गया, आपके सवाल का जवाब मिल गया. No, may I raise it? अच्छा, everything we will explain even on the basis of the question. That will be the part of course. So it must be included. So never. Okay. 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 So. Okay. Okay. And this is answer of your question. You must note it. Okay. And this is also. Okay. Please be silent, please. Okay. Yeah, please. मैंने फिर एक मिनट. आप ये अप्लाई कर रहे हैं और ये आपको वैल्यू आ रहा है, ठीक है. अच्छा, आगे आप क्या है. ओके नो. अच्छा, अभी हम ये बात कर. तो दिस लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन विल बी इस अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस थ्योरम विच आई हैव प्रूव, दिस लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन विल बी आल्सो द आइगन स्टेट ऑफ द एरिथ ऑपरेटर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस थ्योरम, अकॉर्डिंग टू थ्योरम, थ्योरम एक्स कह दो, थ्योरम एक्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू थ्योरम एक्स, द लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस आइगन स्टेट, अकॉर्डिंग थ्योरम एक्स, द लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन, द लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ आइगन स्टेट अल्फा एंड बीटा अल्फा विल आल्सो डीजनरेट आइगन स्टेट ऑफ ऑपरेटर अल्फा विद डीजनरेट आइगन वैल्यू अल्फा. ओके, सो इफ वी अप्लाई ऑपरेटर अल्फा ऑन द स्टेट, व्हाट इज द स्टेट सी वन अल्फा प्लस सी टू. ओके, सी टू, हाँ सॉरी, बीटा अल्फा ओके विद ए सी वन अल्फा प्लस सी टू बीटा अल्फा and eigen value is alpha. Okay. If I say this is I say any this is what is the कोई name दे दो. If I say that this is this state, okay, alpha plus theta. Okay, I have, yeah, yahi rehne do Vishak. So this is if this linear combination is equal to this, okay, I say that that is this. Okay, this. Yes. These are the same. See. Linear same. Okay. No. Okay. This is when we applying on a alpha. This is giving the this, and this will be stick linear. So, if we apply a beta on psi, this will be alpha psi, okay, and again by commutation relation due to, but now case is in, now this is not alpha, but now alpha is the combination of linear combination of this, that is the different, okay. Due to commutating, due to commutating alpha beta to beta alpha, I have already explained it. Take minute. Yeah. Okay. So this may be right is in this way alpha beta psi. Alpha beta psi. Yes. This will be the same.
Yes.
Okay. 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 So now again beta may be a dependent means now this is a new state, okay, beta psi. Now beta psi is new state. Is a new eigen state of alpha operator with same eigen state. Okay. Now beta is the new eigen state of alpha with the same eigen state. Beta is new eigenstate of alpha with same eigen, same degenerate eigen value alpha. Okay. Now, this again, this may be a dependent and may be independent. So, So, alpha, okay, the same eigenvalue, theek hai, same value, please. So, alpha alpha operator state. Okay. Now beta psi is new eigen state of alpha with same eigen value alpha. Okay. Now this may be a dependent. So alpha and alpha are independent, but beta psi may be dependent or इंडिपेंडेंट बीटा साई बीटा अल्फा एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड दैट अल्फा एंड बीटा दीज आर इंडिपेंडेंट एंड दीज आर दीज मे बी डिपेंडेंट दीज मे बी इंडिपेंडेंट इन एज द लॉज ओके If alpha phi, what is the sign? Oh, sorry. If beta phi, what is the beta phi? C1 alpha plus C2 beta R. Dependent, then this will be eigen state of both alpha and beta operator as explained in previous case. If not, agar independent hai, then we will again take linear combination and xi will be new state, new eigen state. So we will repeat this process up till we get it. So we will repeat these steps up till we will get dependent state. So So at the end we will find the states of alpha and beta will be seen. What I have said, I summarize it. If you have an alpha and if you have a if alpha and beta are two distinct states, if two are a dependent state or same state, then these state will be a same. I have already told. Okay, if they are a two distinct state, then their linear combination will be also the state of the same state. I have proven the theorem. Okay. And that state may be a linear, that state will be the state of both. But if not, if they are independent again, then we will take the linear combination of this state with the old one state, and we will repeat this step up till we will get the state which are depending. Yes. And then it will be again the state of the beta 2. So it means we always get the same state for commutative operators. Okay. Last time we was discussing about that if two states are commuting, okay, their eigenstate will be same. Okay. that lecture will be continued today. Okay. Now we will prove reverse wise. Okay. If two states has the same eigenstate with different eigenvalue, they will be commuting. Okay. Now exercise is reverse wise. If two eigen operators have same eigenvalue may be a different. Okay, if two eigen operators have same eigenstate, if two eigen operators have same eigenstate, nevertheless may have distinct eigen value. If two eigen operator have same eigen state, nevertheless may have distinct eigen values, will always be commutating. Okay. If two different eigen operators, okay, you may write distinct. If you have two different operators, okay, if you have two different eigen operators which have same eigenstate, okay, they may have a different eigenvalues. They may have a same eigenvalue. They may have a different eigenvalue, but state will be same. Then they will always commute. Okay, that is, you may say that is the reverse of the previous theorem. Okay. If two eigen operators have same eigen state, then they will be commuting. Okay. I will explain it now. For example, now I will prove it. Mean if two eigen state, if two eigen operator have same eigen state. Mean if you have alpha and beta two operators. Okay. Two distinct operators. If alpha and beta are two distinct operators having same eigenstate, let that eigenstate is psi. Okay. Both have a same eigenstate, that is psi, with the distinct eigen values which are alpha and beta respectively. They have a same distinct eigen values. Okay, what is the meaning of this? If alpha operator is applying this same eigenstate and this is giving the eigenvalue alpha and psi, okay, this one relationship is this, and if beta is also applying on the same state, okay, but have different eigenvalue, that is beta psi, okay. So actually this is the result. Okay, these eigenstates are the same, but eigenvalues may be a different, may be a same and may be a different. Alpha beta may be a same, alpha beta may be a different. Okay, we have to prove that they will always commuting. This is given, okay, in mathematics you can say that is given, this is given, and what do you have to prove? That alpha and beta equal to zero. Have to prove. So these are the two things, okay? So if I say this is equation one and this is equation two, because we have to prove that we don't need it, okay? Actually this is given, okay? These are the things. If alpha one is this and okay, if I multiply one with the beta, equation one, and with alpha, equation two, and subtract. Firstly, multiply beta with the equation one, and subtract, multiplying beta with the equation two. Okay, then you will get beta. Okay, no. If sorry, this is true, but I know some students may be will not comfortable with this. If we multiply equation two with alpha minus beta with the equation one, okay, then you will get alpha beta psi, okay, subtraction minus beta alpha psi, okay, this will be alpha a, sorry, so alpha is eigenvalue that will be come out from, as I have already explained in a previous lectures. So okay, so first equation two with the alpha, okay, you will get beta, okay, alpha, sorry, beta alpha operator psi minus, okay, alpha, we have multiply this equation with the alpha, so alpha plus alpha will come out, and this term will be multiplied with the this. Okay, but we from what is this? We may write what is this? This is alpha beta psi. Left side is equal to this. Okay, and according to from equation one and from equation one one and from equation two. Okay, by putting this value, when operator alpha will be applied on this, this will be converted to alpha, and when beta will be applied, this will be converted into b. Okay, so then this will become beta alpha psi minus alpha beta psi. Okay, and we may write beta alpha minus alpha beta psi. From equation one, alpha psi is equal to alpha is eigenvalue. This I put the value alpha psi. From this, for this I put the value equation. Okay, have you got it? So what will be happen? Because alpha beta are eigenvalue, as I have already explained it many and many times, that will be like a number, okay? And there are, I agreed, there are many numbers which are the Grassmann numbers, they are non-commuting numbers, but your course, if you are belong to the undergraduate level course, our undergraduate level course is a very simple as compared to graduate level course. So that's why up till this course, we will assume that you are not a higher mathematician, so you will come, the numbers will be commuting for only for your course, okay? So these number are commuting. Okay. Okay, this is not a supersymmetry. Okay, this is simple quantum mechanics. When you will come in on the quantum field, quantum field theory, then we will discuss if the even if the numbers are not commuting, then what will be happening? Okay. But in this case, these numbers are commuting. Okay. Eigenvalue are commuting, so that will be a zero. The zero. Required results for quantum mechanics undergraduate level course. Okay, so this is only for the under level course. Yes, maybe it is not necessary for you, but for me it is very necessary, because when you will come in a quantum field theories and other high level theories, then you may ask, sir, why you have written this. Okay, so next exercise is that for if alpha and beta are two distinct Hermitian operators if alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian operators, mean they are it may be possible that in your examination paper I not write the Hermitian operator, I may write the physical operator. I have already explained you that physical operators, Hermitian operator mean physical operator, and physical operator means Hermitian operator, because all physical all operators corresponding to the physical observables will be Hermitian. So if I write two distinct, I may write a physical operator, or may I write, the operators corresponding to physical observables. Okay, and you may write it. If alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian operators, okay, then operator gamma that is the equal to the commutation relation of alpha and beta will not Hermitian, okay, will not physical operator. Will be not physical operators. Gamma will be not operator. Physical operator. That will be operator. They may be operator, but they may not. They will not a physical operator. Okay. They will be a skew Hermitian operator. Why that will be a skew Hermitian operator? They may be a physical. The only choice is that. That will, if that is operator, then that will be not a physical operator. If that is a physical, then that will be a Z. Okay, we will prove it. Okay, so if alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian operator, okay, let alpha and beta are two operators, okay, they are giving the gamma, alpha beta is equal to gamma, okay, if you are not interested to this, I think we may write in this way too, that if we write in this way, okay, actually we are interested only find what gamma is Hermitian or not Hermitian, okay, so that is the simple relationship that is given, okay. If I expand it, this will be alpha beta minus beta beta alpha, okay, and this will be equal to gamma, okay, yes. So if I take Hermitian conjugate both sides, okay, may I write in this way, okay, I have taken the Hermitian conjugate, okay, so when apply Hermitian conjugate it will reverse the order, because I have already proved that the if we take the transpose, then AB will be equal to BA, okay, and for complex conjugate they will be commuting, okay. So as we apply this will become a beta Hermitian operator, alpha Hermitian operator minus alpha Hermitian operator beta Hermitian operator. Why? Because we know that AB, if we take that will be a B and A, okay, the order will be changed. I have changed the order, that this alpha beta will be convert beta alpha and this beta alpha will become a alpha beta, okay. I have written the minus. There is no multiplication. Okay. Okay. So.
This time we have a b whole square like this, so a square b square like this. Like a minus b whole square.
No, that is not. That is totally different. Actually, okay. Yes. Ye. नहीं, वी हैव नॉट एक्चुअली दिस व्हेन यू टेक हर्मिशन ऑपरेटर दिस इफ दैट विल बी हर्मिशन देन दैट विल बी चेंज, ओके, इधर साइन आएगा, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू दिस एक्चुअली आई एम आंसरिंग यूर क्वेश्चन इफ ए एंड बी A minus B, you take Hermitian, then that will be A Hermitian and B Hermitian. Okay, okay. So that's your question. Okay. Actually, why I have not written, because I have repeated it again and again, many and many times. Okay. So even if there is a minus plus, the sign will remain the same. Okay. It will not affect on the, because transpose not affect on the addition and subtraction. Transpose always affect on the multiplication, okay, but for multiplication the order will be changed, but for the addition or subtraction transpose will not affect, okay.
Yes.
Anyway, this is okay, now what is this, if I take the minus common, okay, may I write in this way that alpha dagger, okay, alpha dagger, okay. Now, given is that alpha and beta are two distinct Hermitian operators, but alpha dagger is alpha, beta dagger is beta, okay, for operators, why these are this Hermitian operators, and it is given in exercise. Okay. It is not necessary they are Hermitian, but that is given in exercise if alpha beta are Hermitian of it. Okay. That is given that alpha beta are Hermitian of it. If they are a Hermitian operator, so that means their Hermitian conjugate will be same. Okay. If their Hermitian conjugate are the same, then this become a beta alpha minus beta alpha minus alpha beta. Okay. And this is the, we don't know anything about the gamma. We have not proved anything, and so they will remain the same. Okay, we can't write it in the form of this, this, because no condition is given about that. We have to find what is that. Okay, we don't know what is that, but we have to find what is that. Okay, so that means that will remain a Hermitian conjugate. Okay, so if we take common minus alpha beta minus beta alpha, that will be a gamma Hermitian. Okay, I have taken minus, I've taken sorry, this this is not commutation relation, this is okay, I have taken the minus common, this become a minus negative, this become a plus. Minus minus multiply, when we multiply minus with the minus, that will be plus, and when we multiply plus with the minus, then that will be a plus. Yeah, this become a plus. Okay, okay, and we isko hum idhar le ja sakte hain, so I can write. Okay, minus common liye. Okay, so no. Okay, so you will get alpha and beta. Operator is yes, minus gamma. No, because gamma is not, there is not written any type, and the gamma is Hermitian. Now only alpha and beta are Hermitian, and so this is equation 2, and this is equation 1. Okay. Both are the same. Okay, left hand side and one, and left hand side of the one and two are the same. So from one and two, we have gamma Hermitian conjugate is equal to minus. This implies that gamma Hermitian is equal to minus gamma. Skew Hermitian. So this is not a physical operator. Okay. So gamma will not, we have proved that gamma will not a physical operator. So gamma will be a skew Hermitian. Yes, you must try it with the help of, that is your assignment. Okay. 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 I think you have noted it. Okay. Now, may I? No. The next exercise is yes, you may take a like a X and P as a, okay, but firstly we have to solve some theorems, then we will deal. Okay, theek hai. Okay, number, yes.
तो
ना एक मिनट आई नाउ यू वांट टू से इफ आई टेक द हर्मिशियन कंजुगेट ओके इफ आई टेक द हर्मिशियन कंजुगेट दैट विल बी इक्वल टू दिस ओके एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस फॉर्मूला ओके व्हेन यू टेक द अगेन द हर्मिशियन कंजुगेट दिस विल बी But this will the Hermitian conjugate will remain here, okay? M minus beta Hermitian conjugate alpha, and that's okay. Yes. Okay. So. No. If they are Hermitian, then that will be equal to operator. If they are not Hermitian, then will not equal. Because here we don't know gamma is of Hermitian or not. That's why we have not written gamma is. Why alpha Hermitian conjugate equal to alpha? Because it is given. It is given. There will be otherwise. Okay. किधर माइनस है? ये माइनस कौन लिया यार माइनस इधर लेके उधर चला किधर नहीं इधर तो आटा चेंज ही नहीं किया वो बता इधर मैंने माइनस नहीं किया इधर ये माइनस आ गया आई हैव टेकन दी कॉमन माइनस फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन देन दिस विल बिकम एंड देन आई शिफ्टेड इट टुवर्ड ओके ओके एंड एनीवे ओके आई थिंक आई मे अरेंज ओके From if that comes, that is true, okay. But from above results, but if alpha beta is equal to iota gamma, if that is iota gamma, okay. As in that case, then gamma will be Hermitian. Why? Yes, your question is because iota will change the sign. Because if you take the alpha beta as a Hermitian conjugate, then that will become minus iota gamma. And if you compare the coefficient, actually you take the I know that maybe a create a problem for some students. That will become a minus iota. The Hermitian conjugate of minus iota. This will be gamma. Okay, that will be. If you compare these two equations, alpha beta, I have already proved, and this will be equal to minus. We have proved that this will be a beta. Alpha order will be changed as we have done in the previous exercise. This will be equal to. Alpha beta minus iota gamma dagger okay actually when we take the Hermitian conjugate that will be convert the sign I have already okay that will be convert the sign minus minus plus and that will become iota gamma this and this will be equation 2 and this will be equation 1 and 1 and 2 implies that gamma dagger will be equal to gamma okay if this is equal to iota then that will be Hermitian If they are not, then that will be a skew Hermitian. Okay. Name. It is also may be a complex. That may be a complex. That is totally different. Yeah, no, I don't agree. They may be a complex or imaginary. Okay. But if you multiply operator, then this will be not Hermitian. This will be Hermitian. Actually, you are multiplying with the skew Hermitian operator. If you multiplying with the skew Hermitian, then that will be Hermitian. Okay. If you are not multiplying with the skew Hermitian, then that will be not Hermitian. Gamma may be also a complex number. Gamma may also, because that's why that is a skew Hermitian. They may be a complex operator. Okay. That is not important. There is a condition only that the gamma. Oh, anyway, this exercise is completed. Okay. The next exercise is about. करते हैं अभी मेरे ख्याल थ्योरम का ठीक है. इफ अल्फा बीटा आर टू डिस्टिंक्ट हर्मिशियन ऑपरेटर. ओके. इफ अल्फा बीटा आर टू डिस्टिंक्ट हर्मिशियन ऑपरेटर देयर कमोटेशन then there then their commutation will be commutating if and only if alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian operators, then their commutation relation will be commutating if and only if alpha beta then their commutation relation will be Hermitian if and only if they are commuting. If alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian operators, then their commutation relation will be Hermitian if and only if they are commuting. If alpha beta are commuting, then their commutation relation will be Hermitian. Otherwise, their commutation relation will be not a Hermitian. Okay. So. The relationship will be given. If I write here aorta, then the gamma must be a Hermitian. If there is aorta is not given, if simply that exercise was given, जैसे कि पहले दी गई है, जैसे दी थी, so that will be a secure Hermitian. Actually, ये papers में अक्सर बच्चों से पूछा जाता है, so that's why मैंने ये छोटी सी exercise. But the main exercise is the last one. Okay. Okay. If alpha beta are two distinct Hermitian, then their commutative relation will be Hermitian if and if only if they are commuting. Okay. So proof is given that alpha beta should be Hermitian and their commutation relation also Hermitian. Okay. As we know that alpha Hermitian, beta are Hermitian operator, as we okay. If they are Hermitian, if we take Hermitian conjugate, then what will be alpha beta minus beta alpha, take a Hermitian conjugate by, as we have already explained, beta. No, Hermitian नहीं, फॉर दिस यू हैव टू विजिट द लेक्चर ऑन हर्मिशियन ऑपरेटर्स एंड हर्मिशियन वैल्यू, ओके, हर्मिशियन फंक्शंस. आई थिंक यू ऑलवेज कम फ्रॉम स्लीपिंग. So, if please be silent. B, beta, alpha, beta, alpha, minus beta, alpha, beta. Okay. 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 This will be equal to this. Beta, alpha, alpha, beta. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Since alpha dagger is equal to alpha, beta operator is equal to beta, given these because two are Hermitian operators. So
beta,
alpha, minus alpha, beta. Okay.
Yes.
And this may be right as no, there is no gamma. Okay. Alpha, beta, minus
beta
alpha, and this is minus alpha beta.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So this will be equal to this. Please, this is equal to this.
Yes,
so if you take a Hermitian operator of commutation commuting of two operators, that will be minus
alpha
beta operator. So the they will be always Hermitian conjugate. Okay, that will be equal to this. If that is the Hermitian, if kya likha hai, if they are commutating mean zero. Okay, if they are Hermitian, they are two exercise, if and only if mean two exercise. If they are Hermitian, they will be commutating. One exercise is that if they are Hermitian, they will be commuting. The second is if they are commuting, they will be Hermitian. Okay, so first one is if alpha beta is Hermitian, then alpha beta must be commuting mean
zero.
We have to prove it. Firstly, we have to prove it. Okay, this is a relationship. Okay, we have drawn this relationship. Okay, if they are because we have proved that this equal to this, I say that from this equation, this is a question x. Okay, if alpha beta is Hermitian, then it must be. Now we have to prove it. Okay. अभी बता चल जाता, ठीक है. तो then what will be the proof? Hermitian means alpha beta must be equal to alpha beta. Hermitian means this given. Okay. Put it into equation X. Put in equation X, we have alpha beta operator is equal to minus beta operator. Okay, and if we take at right side, then it means 2 alpha beta operator will be equal to
0,
and this will be implies that 2 is non equal to 0 because 2 is not equal to 0. Okay, so it means the other will be 0. Okay, so this will be 0. That was our required result. And that will be required result. This is question. Okay. There was a two theorem. Actually, if and only if means two theorems. Okay. Now we have to prove it reverse wise. Mean if that is zero. The second is if alpha beta is commuting means zero or commuting. Okay, if alpha beta is commuting, then if alpha beta is commuting, then alpha dagger beta dagger will be Hermitian. Hermitian means beta. Okay. We have to prove. This is given. This we have to prove. Okay. So if you put this is zero. Okay. Okay. Sorry. If alpha beta is zero, then this will be also zero. So they are same. If we put this in equation X, okay, alpha beta dagger is also zero. Okay, and with alpha beta is zero. So both this implies that. If this is 1, this is 2, this implies that 1 and 2 implies that alpha beta dagger is equal to alpha beta operator and both are equal to 0. So both conditions are satisfied. Okay. There. Okay.